everybody. Welcome back to Breakfast with Bob from CLASH Daytona. My name is Bob Babbitt. We're brought to you by the NASCAR Foundation, Daytona International Speedway, USA Triathlon, Aquasphere, and Varlo. Our next guest, Sonja Catano. And it's our first time getting to chat.
Yes.
A pleasure.
Yeah, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. And you've had a really solid year. You got to race on the racetrack at Miami last year, and you got fifth, and then it was like Eagleman fourth, and Mont Tremblant fourth, and Santa Cruz fourth, and 70.3 World 17th.
Yep.
That's pretty solid, and you went to really fun places.
Yeah, it's been a great year.
Right? Miami and Mont Tremblant, one of our favorite places, Santa Cruz, mm-hmm. St. George.
Mm-hmm. I cannot complain.
No. So what got you into this? Did you grow up as like a swimmer, a cyclist, runner?
Yeah, I always grew up as a swimmer. I have an aunt and uncle who were in triathlon.
Back in Massachusetts?
Yep. They did Lake Placid, and that was my first introduction to Ironman in general and long course. So I did some races over the summer locally.
Yeah.
And then after college and working for a bit, I got back into it. That sort of led me to here slowly.
Now, as you went through, mainly as an age grouper, mm-hmm. had you thought of, okay, I want to try to do the Olympic format, or was it always 70.3 full type of thing?
It was definitely sprints, Olympics.
Olympics.
Yeah, those are, I think, most of the local races that
we
have. I didn't know much about long course other than watching my aunt and uncle do it, and I did not want to do a full Ironman.
Oh, no. It seems ridiculous, right?
So that was just kind of my introduction, and I met a coach who kind of taught me about draft legal and the Olympic races.
Yes.
So I dabbled in that for a few years before I started long course last year.
So you dabbled in draft legal. Were you thinking potentially Olympics?
I don't think I ever kind of set my sights that
liked,
high, but
just
I really enjoyed
experience.
It. Yeah, it was a lot of fun. And I don't think my body was ready for the long course. I've always struggled with kind of run distance and being healthy with that. So it was just sort of
stress fracture
transition.
Type of things.
Yep. So we finally found something that's worked, and
Hard part is finding that, you know, that what works, because a lot of people end up with, you know, multiple stress fractures.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's funny because sometimes the longer distance seem, because you don't run as fast, mm-hmm. sometimes it keeps you healthier.
Yeah. And I've definitely been healthier now that I've started long course then.
Isn't that funny?
I wasn't short.
It doesn't seem to make sense. I got an idea. If you get injured running short, run longer.
Mm-hmm.
That doesn't seem to make a lot of sense.
Yep.
What do you look at as the race that told you, okay, I think I should try to go pro?
Oh, I don't know if I really had a race like that. I remember it was about, what, I think 5 years ago.
Okay.
My coach had come to me and said, I think you could do this. I'd never trained through the winter. I'd never used a trainer before. If it got below 60, I didn't ride my bike.
Right.
So I did that for the first time ever, and I came into March where there was a qualification race, and I felt like I've never been this fit this time of the year before. And it just sort of happened. I had a great race, and I figured I may as well just take my pro card and see what happens.
See what happens,
that.
Right?
Yeah, yep. And my first couple pro races in draft legal went really well, so no regrets with that decision. I knew none of this existed, and each time I was like, oh, this is really cool, let's try that. So it's been just kind of a fun exploration into pro triathlon.
Now, are you full-time pro triathlete? You have a real job is on top of it?
I was full-time for about 3 years, and I just started a new job in January, so I work about 6 hours a day.
And what do you do?
I work for university. I'm an event manager
for a
German department. Yeah.
I bet the balance is good.
It is. It's really good. It definitely forces me to be a bit more efficient, and I can't take as many naps, but it is what it is.
The nap, the massage, the sort of the perks of the sport.
Exactly. The recovery. I mean, that was quitting my job a couple of years ago. I noticed that you really get more time for the recovery. It wasn't even just the training. But I had a good opportunity for a great job, and I couldn't turn it down earlier this year.
Yeah, and the recovery is a little bit underrated mm-hmm. by, you know, like I think Americans look at recovery a little differently than mm-hmm. other people. If you go to Kenya and it's time to recover, you lay down and watch the clouds go by,
mm-hmm.
right? Where here, you're doing your social media, you're going grocery shopping, you're doing errands.
Yep.
It's not real recovery.
Mm-hmm.
And you sort of learn that when you go pro, you find out what real recovery
is.
Exactly.
And
how big a difference.
It's
you really
important.
Do. Mm-hmm. So you tend to do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I mean, you don't hesitate to do 5, 6, 70 half marathons, basically, in a year.
Mm-hmm. And I know some people do more, but I did two races. I think Eagleman and Mont Tremblant were 2 weeks apart.
Ooh.
And I was hoping to do Watkins Glen 2 weeks after that, and that is
Your
not the way
like,
my body
no.
works. And mentally, too. I definitely struggle to bounce back so quickly. I need a little time to reset, yes, get back into a training plan.
What is it about the sport that obviously entices you?
I don't know. I was always a swimmer, so I've definitely always enjoyed individual, right, you know, the long distance sports. But I think the just having the three different sports and the people you meet and the variety of training you can, right, have too, it never really gets old.
How different has it been being a pro from when you were racing as an age group?
I think it's a big difference. It becomes a little bit more of your identity, even though you try not to let it do that. And I've done a good job of, you know, there's me and I am a triathlete, but that's not everything that I am.
Right.
But it definitely just takes up more, and I feel obligated to train more and be able to perform at that level.
Right.
At
if you're
level.
A pro and exactly. you go to the starting line, you yep. don't want to be.
Like yeah. I owe it to myself and everyone who's helped me along the way. And it's just, I think, a different dynamic too. I always try to go to races and have fun and do the best that I can, but right. I definitely, especially when I started, struggled a little bit more with just the pressure and mm-hmm. everything, because I feel like there is a lot more on the line. But yeah, it feels like it's just a little bit of a dynamic, but that's definitely the pressure I put on myself. And as I've gotten older and been as pro for a few years, I think I've done a better job of treating it like it's any other right. race, and I'm here to have fun, and that's why I started doing this.
So when you raced Clash last year, and I'm guessing that was your first time on the track?
Yes, yep. It was very cool.
Yeah, and that was a little different than this because you mm-hmm. had a road course. You yeah. had some in and out of the saddle, mm-hmm. some, you know, almost a criterium type of yeah. format. Have you been on this track?
I did, yeah. I biked around this morning, and big difference from Miami.
Right.
Really big difference. And I train, most of my biking is on the trainer year-round.
So you're used to just being in the aero position
yeah,
for hours and hours and yep. hours.
I love the trainer, so I'm excited to just
you love the
put
trainer.
My head down. I do.
Oh my God, well this is a huge yes. step from the trainer.
Yep.
Yeah.
So that should be pretty exciting. But yeah, I thought Miami was a huge, I've never been on a race course before, race course and everything, and then I came here and I'm thinking, wow, this is definitely huge.
Well, you know what's so funny is we came here first. Mm-hmm. So then we went to Miami, and Miami looks minuscule
yeah.
compared to this
yep.
place.
I can imagine.
Yeah, Miami looks like it could go inside here. Mm-hmm. It's this place is so massive.
Yep, it is.
And it's funny because you can see pictures and video, but until you're on that track the stadium around you mm-hmm. and realize that you're sort of an ant mm-hmm. and here's this gigantic thing around you, it's pretty cool.
It is. I was one of the first ones on because I made sure to get on at 8 this morning since yes. I have work. And it was just like, oh, this is all to myself. But it's so, I feel so tiny just in this huge course. But it's a neat experience.
Good for you. That's cool. And what are any specific goals for Friday?
No. No, it's the last race of the season. I just
yes.
get out there. I've been fortunate to be healthy up until this point. And earlier, I never was able to do a full season. So it's just.
That's
just,
cool.
Yeah, be able to pull it all together.
Your
from
body's
March
understanding
to,
what this takes.
Yeah, exactly. So get out there and have some fun.
And then next year, any ideas on what you want to do?
No.
Or just let it come by play.
Yeah,
here?
We'll get through this race, go on vacation for a little bit.
Right, and then, you
then
between work
next.
And this, you'll figure out what you want to do next
exactly.
year.
Exactly.
Have a great race.
Thank you.
A pleasure to get to meet
yeah,
you.
Too.
And I hope you have, you know, hopefully we'll see you in Miami as well.
Definitely.
All right. Sonja Catano has been our guest. Everybody, again, Breakfast with Bob from Clash Daytona. Hold on. We'll be right back.